The life of Christ is the greatest story ever told. We need to know who Jesus is, what he taught, how he lived, and what he promised. In this second lesson, we shall look at the geography of Palestine during the time of Jesus. The word geography is a Greek word which means earth description. The ancient Greeks coined the term and were the first to develop geography as a scientific discipline. Geography can be broadly defined as the science that describes the surface of the earth and its associated phenomena that include climate, people, animals, and products. These factors, in many ways, determine the destiny of civilizations, their economic base, political confrontations, military campaigns, travel routings, location of cities, and designation of national boundaries. The Bible's reference to the geography of the New Testament land is accurate and reliable. We shall concentrate on the geographical features which influence the course of political events in the Old Testament times up to the first century New Testament. The Jews were originally pastoralists, but changed to fishing when they settled in Palestine around the Sea of Galilee. Many of them were involved in fishing activities such as making boats, selling fish, making fishing nets, and doing actual fishing. The area around the Dead Sea was remote. The land there could not support life in any way. The only people found living there were the Essenes, who wanted to isolate themselves. Jordan River, on the other hand, is a tiny river which could even be crossed easily by walking across. The Jordan was acting as a boundary in the Old Testament. There were five main provinces in Palestine. But for the sake of this study, we shall look at only three of them. The name Galilee means circle or district. Its fuller expression is district of the Gentiles, as can be denoted from the book of Isaiah chapter 9, verse 1, or Matthew chapter 4, verse 15. The term was applied to the northern district of Palestine, which was surrounded on three sides by foreign or Gentile nations. Galilee was Jesus' home province. Most of his disciples came from here. There was no major urban centers during Jesus' day. Jesus traveled and ministered in many cities and villages in Galilee. The region is composed primarily of hard ridges of limestone and plateaus of soft chalk. It was densely forested and sparsely populated. Its rugged terrain and isolation made it a region of escape of Israelites resisting political dominion by foreign powers. Since Galilee served as the location for most of Jesus' ministry, a survey of this region is necessary for a thorough background of Christ's life and ministry. A brief survey of some of the major sites in Galilee will shed light on the life of Jesus. Capernaum. This was the town of Peter, Andrew, James, and John. It is located on the northwest shore of the Sea of Galilee. Capernaum means the city of Nahum, and it became the center for Christ's ministry in Galilee after his rejection at Nazareth, Matthew chapter 4, verses 12 to 14. Jesus performed some of his greatest miracles there, Mark chapter 2, verses 1 to 12, and taught in its synagogues, Mark chapter 1, verses 21 and 22. It was Jesus' turning point during his ministry. Nazareth. This was the home of Joseph and Mary, where they settled when they returned from Egypt after the death of Herod the Great. Matthew chapter 2, verses 19 to 23. It is here where Jesus lived and grew to adulthood. Nazarenes were lightly esteemed by other Jews in the Galilean region because it was just 6 kilometers away from Sepphoris, which was the Roman capital in Galilee. This means that most of the workers and the servants of the Roman oppressors were people of Nazareth. The name of the town was not mentioned even once in the Old Testament, hence thought of as unworthy of anything good coming from it. John chapter 1, verse 46. Chorazin. This was a city in the hills of Galilee, which was just 3 miles north of Capernaum. Jesus performed many miracles there, but the people did not respond with repentance. So Jesus rebuked them for their unbelief. Matthew chapter 11, verses 20 and 21. Bethsaida was the home of 3 of Jesus' apostles, namely Philip, Andrew, and Peter, as written in John chapter 1, verse 44, and chapter 12, verse 21. It was a small fishing village on the northeast shore of the Sea of Galilee. It is in this area that Jesus healed a blind man mentioned in Mark chapter 8, verse 22. It was also from here that Jesus fed the 5,000, Cana of Galilee. This was the home of Nathanael, as recorded in John chapter 21, verse 2. Cana was where Jesus chose to perform his first miracle, again, John chapter 2, verses 1 to 11. He later healed the nobleman's son here, John chapter 4, verses 46 to 54. Caesarea Philippi. This town is located in the southern slopes of Mount Hermon. It is in Caesarea Philippi that Peter made the great confession to Jesus, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God," Matthew chapter 16, verse 16. It was called Caesarea Philippi to distinguish it from the other Caesarea, which was on the shore of the Mediterranean Sea. It was named so by Herod the Great's son called Philip. Judea was the most urbanized center in the day. Most people in Judea were craftsmen, businessmen, skilled workers. They cultivated a higher standard of living. They tended to be arrogant and proud due to their residence. Some of the major cities in Judea include Jerusalem. It was the site of the temple. It was the religious capital of the Jews all over the world. The Romans had a great number of soldiers stationed in Jerusalem. Bethany is another town in Judea. It was a home of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus. It was a suburban town on the outskirts of Jerusalem. It acted as Jesus' base while in Jerusalem. Bethlehem. This town acted as a provincial town in rural area. People here kept flock. It was the city where Jesus was born, as was prophesied by the Old Testament prophets. Jericho. This town lied along the River Jordan. It is the town that Jesus used in his parable about the Good Samaritan. This was a province between Galilee and Judea. They were biologically different from the Jews. When many Jews were captured and taken to Assyria, some of them intermarried with the Assyrians. Also, the remnants were willing to intermarry the Canaanites around them. They became different in culture, in language, food, and even religion. These were the people who formed the Samaritan community. They had different religious rituals. They were despised by the Jews because, one, they were half-castes. Two, they were northerners who revolted against the king of Israel when the kingdom divided. They were considered the lowest form of life. When the Jews went to Judea to offer sacrifices in the temple in Jerusalem, they had to cross the Jordan River, enter Decapolis to the east, and then south to Perea, and then cross back the river into Judea. Jesus refused to abide by this prejudice of the day. He passed through Samaria. He sat down there and had a talk with the Samaritan woman. The important town in this district was Sychar, where Jesus met the Samaritan woman. The Samaritans themselves acknowledged that Jesus is indeed the Savior of the world, John chapter 4, verse 42. Two other important towns in Samaria are Caesarea, which was a settlement for the Roman governor, and Shechem. This refers to the time between the closing of the Old Testament period and the opening of the New Testament. It begins with the closing of the book of Malachi and the beginning of the book of Matthew. It covers a period of 400 years. This 400 years between the Testaments is often thought of as the silent ages of Israel's history. This is a period which is regarded as an age of transition in the Bible land. It was a time when predominantly Jewish ways were gradually shadowed by Greek culture, language, and philosophy. This is the period which actually sets the stage for the New Testament period. Thank you for watching this episode on the geography of Palestine during the time of Jesus. Join me next time as we look at the political development of Palestine before and during the time of Jesus.